So when the long bones appear, the mesenchyme, which means undifferentiated mesoderm, kind of forms, this is the long bones, kind of forms just a mass. Well, I'm just going to say this is the mass here. Then later the joint appears. So we don't have like a bone and then a space and then a bone and a space. We have a unit, and then the space appears and opens, and then it grows more, and then a space opens. And then here, and then the space opens for the two bones, and then here, 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 and here. So do that with me with one of your arms. It starts with the scapula. And this is a unit here. Go across your shoulder. And then the space appears, and it moves this bone kind of, the distal bone. Then the unit grows, and then the space appears, and it, this bone goes this way, and this bone comes back to the origin. I'll explain that more in a minute. Then this bone grows, and then these bones appear. They appear because the space appears. Then the unit goes over here, and then all the little wrist spaces open. And then et cetera, until finally, and you put your hand up, and it's longer.
Yes.
You did it. Because the space lengthens the arm or the leg. And a lot of times when people want to stretch, they're stretching the muscles and the ligaments instead of the space. So with your other arm, feel the difference between kind of stretching and just letting this each space appear. And that arm will become longer without stretching. Because we grow through space. And when there's a problem, we forgot the space. We keep thinking we have to do something with the bones rather than the space grows us. Another thing that happens is someone wants to do a side bend. They take the scapula and they move it. Does that feel familiar? Do it so I'm not having all the fun. You can't grow from there, because you lost your place of origin. What I mean by that is take your other arm and don't stretch it. Just lift it. And then leave your scapula here, but let a space move your humerus. And then let the space move your each thing. But your scapula stays here because it's a measurement, it's a calibration. So once you get to the end, then move your scapula. Because your arm is already created. Then if you put your other arm up, it's going to be longer. So in all these yoga classes and Pilates and whatever, if the person does this, they can't do it. So you don't have to say, what did Bonnie say? It doesn't matter what I said. If you move your scapula, do it, then try to find the spaces. You can't, because you've lost the original place of measuring. So the same thing happens with the pelvic half. If you do something to lengthen the side, does that look familiar? Lengthen your side. You can't lengthen the leg because you lost the place of origin. But you leave your pelvis there, and then you just keep lengthening the spaces. And then that leg is going to be taller. So stand, we're going to do it more detailed, but feel how this could be a class. Lift your scapula, lower your pelvis. There's no space. You've lost the hook, not the hook, the seed from which to grow. So release your scapula. Maybe just do one at a time. Release your pelvis and then this space appears, and then you have a unit, and then that space, and that space, and that space, and that space, and you step on it, it's going to be longer than your other leg. Where if you do this kind of thing, you just stiff. It's the space that holds the information. It's a really interesting thing, I think. So let's look at another piece. So when that space appears and the joint is created, what's left are the ligaments and the tendons and the fascia. Well, ligaments are fascia, specialized fascia. No muscles. Muscles come from the paraaxial, from the somites. They have to migrate in after the local structure is developed. So the bones, the fascia, blood vessels, dermis, these are local lateral plate forming. I forgot the English, but anyway, they're rising from that. So the muscles and the nerves come in from the axis when the structure's basically complete. So we need the muscles and the nerves to move, not to create structure. And I feel that's where we get lost. We're trying to get the muscle, pull down your scapula, do this, turn this. We're trying to create the form through muscles, but they had nothing to do with the form. They had to do with the movement.